Hi Apurva, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you, sir?
I'm good too, thank you. So can you tell us something about yourself?
Yes, sir. My name is Apurva Gupta and I'm from Chhatarpur, Madhya Pradesh. Recently, I have graduated from Medicaps University Indore in BTech Computer Science. Also, I have done two internships during my degree and also done in one software testing certification course by Udemy. And I was able to develop a strong understanding in software testing during my studies. And yeah, this is a short and
Right, great. So, first of
Okay.
all, many, many congratulations to you. Right, you have got
Thank
selected
you,
in one
sir.
of the MNC company. So, would you like to share
Thank you,
your
sir.
experience? Yeah. So, would you like to share
Yeah,
your
definitely.
experience? How many interview rounds were there, and how did you come to know about the position there?
Yeah. Okay, so there was total 4 to 5 rounds. I can't conclude the 5 round as an interview because the 5th round is just HR discussion about the salary and the services or the policies. Besides that, I have passed 4 round. Basically, very first round is for HR screening, and there are 2 technical rounds, and the last round is like aptitude and coding test. And I have applied different companies from different portals. There are so many portals are in the market which provide a great package as a fresher. So yeah, I have applied one of the portal and then got selected and passed all the round and got the job.
Great. So you were mentioning you also got aptitude rounds, right?
Yes.
So
Yes.
what kind of questions were asked, and how did you prepare for aptitude?
Okay, so in aptitude reasoning, I have different sections like non-verbal reasoning, verbal reasoning, pictography, data analyzing questions. Every section has six questions for 6 minutes. I have 2 to 3 sections related to basic computers because I am a computer science engineering. This is for software. The few questions were related to operating systems and database management and also networking. And I have one coding question in which the basic, very basic coding question like for implementing array and finding some elements.
Okay. So would you
Yes.
like to tell something about the testing interview questions that were asked to you, if you are able to recall them?
Yes. Yes, I am totally recall them. Basically, the very first in technical round, they ask you about the introduction part, and I noticed that most of the question they were asked related to regression and sanity testing. Most of the questions and the scenario based questions are also based upon regression and sanity testing. Besides that, they were also asking the term which I have used, like during I when I'm answering the what is regression testing. So whenever I introduce a new term, they also raise a cross questioning, and they just ask me the bug life cycle and software testing life phases. What is software testing? And the very first question the interviewer asked me, like, why do I want a job in testing field? This is very first and common question. And the question also arises in second round of testing. Basically, in my experience, the first round of the first technical round is like more technical question were raised. But in the second technical round, very less technical question were raised. And beside, they were asking you about your personality. In second round, I was also complimented by the interviewer, the way I represent myself. Basically, he liked me the way I represent. So he doesn't ask me much technical question, but he asked me a question, user requirements and client requirements. What are the user requirements and client requirement? This is basically arise a question when we talk about the project and product. So this question were asked to me, and yeah, the very basic question like type of testing. So most of the question are scenario based. They were asked me the test cases for Facebook login page, positive test cases as well as negative test cases.
Okay.
And also the severity and priority. Every interview I have been faced at least a single question based on the severity and priority.
So were please go ahead. Please go ahead.
Your last question is about the usability testing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So were you given some application to test and to find bugs during your interviews?
No.
Okay, that didn't happen. So these were all theoretical based questions, no practical round.
No, sir. Actually, I was mentioned in my CV that I know the automation tool for performance testing, that is JMeter. Mm-hmm. Some of the question also arise by the performance testing, like the very first question is what is load testing, or load testing, how differ load testing from performance testing. Basically, they just want to check me, like load testing is a type of performance testing. Those terms are individually independent. And some of the question asks for JMeter, like what is JMeter, what is the flow of JMeter, what is the sampler, listener, very basic questions.
So basically what you have written in the CV, whatever you have written, those questions were asked to you.
Yes. And I saw some of the times up in previous interview, when I'm giving the interview for a manual tester, as manual tester, the very first question the interviewer asked me, do you know any scripting language or do you know any automation tool? The very first question that arises in any interview, nothing matters like interview for the manual tester or automation tester. So, yeah, that's why I learned JMeter.
So basically, they are looking for exposure to some of the scripting language or some of the automation tools.
Yeah, they don't ask you any question about the scripting language or anything. They just want to know you are aware of that, because the profile is for manual tester. They are also, interviewer also aware for that. The profile is for manual tester. So they don't, they never going to ask you a question related to automation. They just want to check your personality, how eager you want to learn, how reliable you are. That's what I understand.
Great.
They never asked me the question about the automation. Although I have a good understanding in Java and I know the basic coding skills in Java. So they never asked the question related to Java. Even though I mentioned that I have a strong understanding in Java, they never asked me a question because the profile is basically for testing. So they have also their training program in which they will train any intern from manual to automation. So if you don't know the any scripting language, that doesn't worry about that. You just boost your resume by adding any any tool, automation tool, by adding JMeter or by adding like API testing, anything.
Okay. Great. So coming back to this scenario-based question. So one was about Facebook login page, positive, negative scenarios. Any other scenario-based questions that you are able to recall?
No, sir. This is the only question they asked me, because at the end, I have asked them a question about my performance or about the review. And I also mentioned, why didn't you ask me more technical question? Because this my interview hardly goes for 30 minutes, second round. First round is like 40 minutes. For the second round, I asked interview, why don't you ask me about the technical skills that I have mentioned in my CV? They didn't ask me any of certification course. So the interviewer told me, it is very important how you represent yourself. None of matter your technical skills, because you already passed the very first technical round in which they checked your very basic concepts. So yeah, the way you represent, the way you answer is very important.
Absolutely, yeah. So sometimes, you know, what happens is We know the answers, but we fail to articulate the answer in the proper words. And that's where we
Yes.
don't get selected in the interviews. You might have seen a very strong profile who is having good knowledge, who is having good exposure, but they don't represent themselves the way you are telling, right? They don't speak, they don't articulate in a proper manner, and that's why they get rejected, right? But that's a good thing to know.
This, yes, I have suffered the same issue you were talking. You was just talked about the that we don't we know the answer, but we like nervous and hesitate at that point, and we can't answer properly. So I'm a kind of candidate, this type of candidate. But when I was preparing for the interview, so I saw your video many times, your video, how you get mock interviews video in your channel. So I got some point noted down that what need to be understand and what need to be remain. Like you just always told me whenever you are explaining any concepts, try to explain with an example, or it is better to add any real world example so that you can connect with the interviewer, because you always connect with the real world example. The tip you gave one of the mock interview, that's really helped me.
Right. So that's good news. That's good thing to hear that actually mock interviews helped. Okay. Now, how did you came to know about the job opening? Were you applying daily in the Naukri.com or Naukri.com, or were you applying daily on LinkedIn.com?
I have planned my day like from morning, from like 8:30 p.m. to 12:30 p.m. I have to apply jobs as many as I can, because this is the high time. After 12 p.m. I hardly apply any job. I hardly apply. So after 12 p.m. I have start studying the study material which I have, and at the night I revised whole the material which I have studied in whole day. And then the next schedule cycle, as I mentioned, that runs again like from 8:30 to 12 p.m. I applied the multiple jobs from multiple portals like LinkedIn or Naukri.com and Indeed, Internshala, and many more.
Okay, great. So, what do you think? How many pages of resume or CV should be there?
Only one single page.
Single page. Okay. Now, when it comes to,
HR will only see the technical skills or your study background, nothing more.
Right. So, one page of resume, but it should be very clear. And it should be
Yes.
having all the details, consolidating all the things that you have done pertaining to the software testing, because we are looking for software testing job opportunities these days, right? So that's very important. And one more thing I would like to know is, did you pay anything related to the service on Naukri.com, or were you using free account? Hello. Yeah, so I was asking, have you paid anything related to the Naukri.com services, or were you using free account?
I'm using free accounts. I never believe in paid accounts.
Okay. Because many of the people, on the channel are asking, is it useful to use the paid account of Naukri?
It's not required. You need to just consistent. In Naukri.com, there is one technique you need to follow. Then you can tons of interview calls. Just you need to update your profile on daily basis from morning. Like if you are logging 8:30, you just updated one skill, or you need, if you don't have new skills, you just delete one skill and just add same skill so that your profile get upgraded. So there is no means to paid for the Naukri.com. You can get tons of calls on unpaid version as well.
Okay, great. So thank you so much, Apurva, for sharing your success story with us. Wish you all the best for your career. The last
Thank
question,
you.
what is the salary range, if you would like to, share in the company that you are making, as you are a fresher. So many people over here are freshers and they are looking for job opportunities. So what is the range of the salary that you are?
From 3 to 5 LPA. This is the CTC.
Right. That's great news. Okay. So thank you so much, Apurva, for coming today on this channel
Thank you,
and
sir.
sharing your success story. And once again, congratulations and wish you all the best for your
Thank you,
future.
sir.
Yeah.
Thank
Thank
you.
you.